Anyways, this is an ambush. Hello, everyone. So there are a lot of people here that are like my ogas, so I'm loyal. So it's not like I know anything, but we just share ideas and what I've discovered over time about us Nigerians. I know a lot of us would be used to the phrase that we're good judges when it comes to other people, and then we're even better lawyers when it relates to us. We like to defend our choices. We like to defend the things we do. Oh, yeah, they mess things up. Things are not working, but what are you doing about it? Now, we see problems, but what if we look at that problem differently and see a need and create a solution? Well, in England, a lot of things have worked here that haven't worked in Nigeria. I'll take Jason Njoku as an example. In England, we have video streaming services. We watch movies. And if he creates something like Iroko TV in England that plays American and British films, do you think he would have been this successful? The answer is no. Because they already have that and the competition is up there. But in a market like Nigeria, there's nothing like that. So he carried the best practice knowledge here and did something that, if any of us does anything related to software development, we'll know that Iroko TV initially wasn't standard, like up there. But for the Nigerian market, it was okay. You know? He got the attention he needed, he got the traffic he needed. He is successful today. Now, what is it that is a problem in Nigeria that you can solve? Sometimes it will cost you nothing. Most of us, we're not even employable. Sometimes, even me, I won't employ myself. For instance, today I was told to come here 10 minutes before 2 o'clock. I got here 2:21. If it was for a job, do you think I'm the right candidate for that job? So, yourself, like, we come in here, we came to do an MSc, and the course is tough, and they don't like to give people they don't like to give people distinction. Do you think you're worth a distinction? It's not about saying, oh, I've prayed, the Lord told me. Yes, the Bible says faith without works is dead. What work are you doing? I was speaking to someone. We might be looking for a very grand platform, you know, and when we're up there, like, I'm struggling to get a PhD that some people have already gotten, anyways. And I'll get awards, and then I'll sit in that grand platform with put my hand on the podium, and I'm like, yeah, you know, seriously, this is how to do this and that and that. You don't need that grand platform. Why don't you start from you, like, change you? There are a lot of nonsense we do that we need to change if we want to be great or successful, unless you want to live a mediocre life. There are certain aspects of yourself. Like today now, that's why I'm looking at Kunle, because I know Kunle will brush me after now for coming at 2:21. You know? You should have those kind of people in your life. And you should be that person to yourself as well. Like, what am I doing that is wrong that I have to change if I want to get to where I'm going? If I impact on him, he impacts on someone else. The other person impacts on someone else. We become better people. Because the fact is that the Nigeria we have and the leaders we have, they came out from us. So if we continue like this, when we get there, do you think we'll be any different? I don't think so. We can have the opportunities, but do we have the drive to do what we want to do? Are we humble enough to ask for help when we need one? Do we even know who to ask help from? I don't want to shoot beyond my time. We'll continue the discussion later. Thank you very much.